Today on Real Estate Now, I want to talk to you about how you can get your offers accepted in this crazy competitive real estate market we're in today. Hi, I'm Eric Lowry with the Lowry team in eXp Realty, and today I want to talk to you for a few moments about what it takes to get an offer accepted in today's very competitive, crazy hot real estate market. So there are a few things that you can do to try to take your offer to the top. You know, what we're seeing right now is homes, listings new come on the market are getting 8, 10, 12 offers submitted on them, sometimes even more. I've seen as much as 20 plus. And so how do you win in that kind of a competition? How do you make your offer stand out from the crowd? First and foremost, you gotta follow instructions. What do I mean by that? A lot of times when a home's listed for sale, in the MLS, in this section that oftentimes it's in the agent remarks section, which you can't publicly see on websites, but it's instructions for the showing agent, things they might need to know about the property. But sometimes there's instructions in there that need to be followed when submitting an offer. And not doing that can, you know, irritate the listing agent when you're not following the specifications they've provided for how to submit an offer or time frames to leave it open, that kind of thing. And so when you don't follow those instructions, you kind of almost automatically get your offer knocked down a bit because you're not following the instructions. So, you know, we got to make sure we follow the instructions. If you're working with a real estate agent who, even in the early stages of just, you know, what homes you're being sent to take a look at online and that kind of thing, if the agent's not following the instructions you're giving them, could be a little bit of a red flag that they're probably not going to follow the instructions when it's time to submit an offer. And like I said, that can knock your offer down a bit. So how do you make your offer attractive? The second thing I would tell you beyond just following the instructions is you want to make sure that you're making the most attractive offer possible. What does that mean? It means we need to connect with the listing agent. We need to find out what the seller's situation is. Are they needing an extremely quick close so that they can get their cash out and move on to wherever they're going next? Or maybe they need an extended closing because they are going to need to then go find a home once they've accepted a contract on theirs. They're going to need to go find their next home and make a purchase, and they need the time to be able to do that. So a delayed closing, you know, might make our offer more appealing. Maybe the sellers are building a home and it won't be finished until a certain date in the future. Well, if you can make that work where it works on the buyer side and appeals to the listing side, the seller side, then the offer becomes more appealing and gives us a better chance. So making sure that we make the most attractive offer in terms of those terms is super important thing to do. Next, you've got to get your best price out there right off the rip. You're going to make an offer, and you need to go at it in today's hot market. You need to go at it with your best price up front. You're probably not going to get a counteroffer, so there's no time for that traditional back and forth kind of thing that we would see, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 years ago. It just doesn't exist largely in today's market. Now, there could be any given scenario where there's a special situation where there was a price that was really overpriced at the start and it's languishing on the market for a bit or something like that. So there's always that one-off kind of situation, but that's not what we're talking about here today. When we're talking about making an offer on a property that's just come on the market or within a day or so, and it's going to be super competitive and we know that, we've got to make sure that we go at it from the get-go with the very best offer right up front. And another thing to consider around the pricing part of it is consider using an escalation clause. An escalation clause can be a thing that can definitely give you a leg up as a buyer competing and trying to do better, to present the best offer over the other competing offers. So, you know, one of the things to consider and speak with your agent about is an escalation clause. The other thing I want to talk about and make you think about in submitting an offer and how to win in today's competitive market is, don't even think about submitting an offer without a pre-approval letter. Just don't do it. you have no chance of winning in a competitive situation without that pre-approval letter. The pre-approval letter needs to go with the offer, not coming behind. Oh, we'll get it there as soon as we can. It needs to go with the offer. And if you want to give yourself the best chance to have your offer accepted, the pre-approval letter should have the property's specific address on it. So if you're making an offer on 123 Main Street, that pre-approval letter should reference 123 Main Street. And it also, at the very minimum, should have the price of the property that is being referenced, or if it isn't property specific, it needs to show a dollar amount that you're pre-approved up to. Anything less than that is a really weak pre-approval letter, and it's going to cause your offer to be rejected. Sellers are just not going to accept those kinds of offers in today's crazy market. And now you might think that gives you a competitive disadvantage in negotiating if it has the amount you could go up to. Well, the truth of the matter is, if you don't have it in there, you're basically saying you are pre-approved for some amount, and you're not really saying what it is. You could be approved for any amount. That could be a lot, could be really little. If a seller doesn't know, there's too much vagueness there, they're just not going to be willing to accept an offer like that. Bonus points here. Bonus tip, if you will, here. Have your lender, your loan officer, reach out to the listing agent as you're submitting that offer. Give them a call and reiterate to them how strong the financing is for your loan, for your offer you're making. That can maybe put it over the top. You don't know which thing will make the difference, but what we know is when we follow a specific system and we do all these things, we give ourselves the very best chance to win in this competitive market. So there's some tips for you to consider when making an offer and how to win in today's competitive market. If we can help you at all in any way, please feel free to reach out to us. We'd love to chat. We'd love to design a strategy to help you get your next home under contract and on your way to closing in this crazy hot competitive market. Feel free to give us a call. You can reach us at 513-586-6900. Thanks a lot, and I'll talk to you soon.